In this video, we're going to talk about our newest addition to our inverter lineup, Tigo Solar Inverters. So Larry, talk to us, give us a brief history about Tigo.
Yes, Tigo's been in the industry for a long time, since 2007. So by solar standards, they're a dinosaur in the industry. They've been producing module level power electronics for years. They started out in Silicon Valley. They're a US-based company, which is one of the things we really like about them. But more recently, they've pivoted just a bit. So in May of this year, they became listed on the NASDAQ to be publicly traded. And they also, within the last year or so, have added inverters to their lineup in addition to the module level power electronics.
So what exactly are they offering now?
Now they have added to their lineup a single phase residential inverter that's a hybrid inverter, so it's battery ready. Not only did they add the inverter, but they also added batteries. So they now have module level power electronics, single phase inverters, and batteries to go along with their single phase inverters.
So let's talk a little bit about the pros and the cons of these inverters. What are some of the pros?
Some of the benefits that I really like about Tigo, well, first of all, they're a US-based company, which is kind of rare these days. Now, their products are not made in the US. I would imagine maybe eventually they'll have plans to do that. But at this point, as far as I know, they don't have any plans to do that. But they are a US-based company, which is helpful. They have a large inverter option. So they have an 11.4. Most of the inverters that we were using previously with single phase string inverters was like a 7.7, maybe a 10. They have an 11.4, which means that now you can get away with fewer inverters for your system. They are also high efficiency, between 97.5% efficiency, which is pretty good. They come with a revenue grade meter right in the inverter. So the inverter reads the power output at revenue grade levels, which is pretty accurate. They have 4 MPPTs, meaning you can do different string lengths into different MPPTs of the inverter. Like I said, they come battery ready. And then they also have a 200% DC to AC ratio. So I've got 11 kilowatt inverter. I can put 22 kilowatts of solar on that inverter. And that gives me just a lot more flexibility with reducing inverters, number of inverters, and that type of thing.
Great. And what are some of the downsides?
Couple of the downsides that we've run into so far using Tigo inverters, one is the price, and they're a little bit more expensive. So because they're a hybrid inverter, they're going to be a little more expensive than your just regular run-of-the-mill inverter. Not bad for a hybrid, but a little more expensive than what we're used to. Then the second thing is they're a little bit challenged on the monitoring side with the inverter. So the inverter's a new lineup for them. They've made DC module power electronics for years, and they've been really good at monitoring there on the DC side. Now they've just got to figure out the monitoring on the AC side. They're going to get there. We've been working with them on it, but that's a con at this point in my mind.
So in summary, Tigo is new to the inverter space, and we've just recently added them to our lineup here. One of the great things is they're a US-based company, not manufacturing here in the United States, but hopefully will in the future. And another great thing about Tigo is that they make larger inverters, which allows our design team some more flexibility in how they design it, and also allows for fewer inverters on a system. The downsides are they're still a little more expensive, and they also don't have the monitoring piece on the AC side figured out yet, and they're working on it. So hopefully in the future we'll see the pricing come down and improve monitoring, and it'll be an improved product overall. Hope you found this valuable. Thanks for watching.